Hi family, it's Ava, your art teacher. So we have a new project this week. It has to do with hand washing. I've been thinking a lot about hand washing and doing a lot of hand washing. There's a special hand washing ritual at Passover, which as you know, is coming right up. And so there's Urchatz, which is part of the Seder. And then there is the ritual hand washing blessing before our Passover meal. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kitshanu b'mitzvotav al netilat yadayim. So blessed are you, God, who commands us to wash our hands. So I invite us to wash our hands with some kavanah. What does it feel like when the water is flowing over your hands? What does it feel like for your hands to be touching each other? Wash your hands in a really tender way that feels like you're really taking good care of yourself and giving yourself a lot of love. It's also a time when we can be thankful. We can be thankful for the water that's coming out of our tap that lets us wash and clean ourselves. We can also pray. We can pray for the health of ourselves and our loved ones and people all over the world. We can pray for the waters of the world to be healed. We can imagine when we wash our hands that that anything that we don't want, that we want to let go of, like fear or anger or, you know, worry, is just washing away as we wash our hands clean. So it can be really powerful. So let's make hand washing special. And we're going to do that by making a visual reminder for ourselves every time we go to wash our hands, when we go to our sink, something special that will catch our eye. That's where the art project comes in. To remind us to really bring our attention and our kavanah to this act of hand washing. Okay, so are you ready for the project? Let's get started. So the first thing you'll need is some sort of vessel that you're going to decorate. So either that is an old jar or bottle or container, anything you have, like maybe look in the recycling bin. You're gonna wanna clean it, of course. But I found this wine bottle and I washed the labels off with hot water and soap. And I also have this soap dispenser that I peeled the label off of. I also have some decorating materials. So what I have on hand is some magazines, some newspaper, some colored paper, scissors, and some sort of way to attach your decorative materials to your vessel. So either that's packing tape, and we do the laminating technique that we did last week. Denise is also gonna show you that method. What I have is Mod Podge, which if you have Mod Podge, this is a great way to go because it seals. It's gonna make it waterproof. So I'm gonna start by cutting out some shapes and images that remind me of water, of washing, of hands, of blessing, right? So it could be also a Star of David. It could be the Red Sea parting, right? Because that's a Passover theme. Also, Miriam is associated with water. Okay, my friends, so I painted some shapes, some watery shapes, and I cut them out. I can just glue them right onto my vessel, and then I can seal them with a layer on top. So I put a patch of glue. So I am now doing the layer on top, and I'm making sure I get past the edges of my shape to make sure it's really sealed. Okay, so I covered my vessel with different shapes. I coated it with a layer of Mod Podge, and I also wrote with a Sharpie some things like, blessed is the water, maim, which is the Hebrew word for water, and al netilat yadayim. Okay, so while that's drying, I'm going to work on a little wall hanging that I'm going to put by my sink. If the Netilat Yadayim blessing speaks for you, then you can write that out. We have included the English and the Hebrew text and the transliteration. But I wanted to write my own blessing. If you're feeling stuck about the blessing, you might ask the questions, what or who are you grateful for that allows you to wash your hands? What or who do you want to pray for? Or what are you washing away? So now I'm going to hand it over to Denise, our other art teacher, and she's going to show you a different way of making a water vessel. Hers is a water pitcher, and it's Passover themed. So take it away, Denise.
Hello, my name is Denise. I'm one of the art teachers at YFE. And I'm going to show you another way to make the pitcher or vessel that we use for our ritual hand washing. Ava is showing you one method. I'm going to show you another. I already wrote my blessing on here with Sharpie. So what I did is I took this container, I washed it out. This was a container that had food in it. And I made sure to dry the exterior, the outside, well before writing on it with Sharpie. I'm going to show you some ways that we can decorate this. And one of those ways is with foil. Now foil, or you could use, if you have cellophane or any other kind of material, you can even decorate with paper, and I'm going to show you how we keep those things from getting wet. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do with this one is cut out a big, nice Star of David. And if you want to draw it first with Sharpie, you can do that. So here I drew a triangle. Now I'm going to draw another one upside down. And one thing I like to do, if I don't want these marks to show up on my final on the exterior of my water pitcher, is I will flip it over when I attach it. So let's go ahead and cut this out. Foil tears very easily, so you have to be very careful. All right, so there is my Star of David. So cool, because now we have a metal embellishment for our pitcher. This side you can see the Sharpie. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tape it on here, and I'm going to try to seal all the ends with tape so that it doesn't trap water underneath. You can use packaging tape or regular tape. I'm going to use regular tape for this one. So I'm going to start with taping it at the very top of the star. And I'm putting it on the side that doesn't have Sharpie. That way, when I put it onto my container, you won't see it. Let's pick a good spot. All right. All right, so I've taped the top. I'm gonna keep adding tape to seal it in. And if you have a lot of packaging tape, you could just have the tape go all the way around so it looks less obvious where the tape stops. Looking good so far. I'm really excited about it. Now, the good thing about using foil is even if some water does get trapped under the tape, it's foil. It's not going to come apart the way paper would. Now, if you do want to make something out of paper, I have a trick for that. So let's make a decoration with paper. All right, I'm going to draw, since this is for Passover specifically, what you could do is draw a picture of each of the foods that would go on the Seder plate. So I'm going to start with parsley, and I'll show you that in a minute. All right, so there's my parsley. And I could color in green. Another trick is if you use Sharpies to color in, and then colored pencils or colored Sharpies, if it does happen to get wet, the colors won't run. So I'm gonna color in green. There's my parsley. And we're gonna cut it out now. I just cut a little bubble around it. You don't have to cut out every little detail. I think this makes it look nice with to have a little border around it. And it makes it easier to cut out. Okay, so now before sticking this onto the pitcher, we're going to laminate it with packaging tape. You could do this with regular tape too. I think it'll be a little bit easier to seal it in with the packaging tape. So that's nice and thick, which will make it easier. We're gonna put this on. It doesn't matter which side you stick it on because we're gonna put tape on both sides. So now I'm gonna open this up more and flip it over. So it's folded around my picture now. It's totally sealed with packaging tape. Now I notice these sides didn't get covered on tape. So I'm gonna do more tape around this way too. So I'm turning it sideways now. All right, so now it should be really well covered from each side. Now I'm gonna cut off the extra tape, but I'm gonna try to leave a little bit of a border around it of tape. I don't wanna cut right up against paper because then it's more likely to get water inside of it. So leaving about just a couple millimeters around, a little lamination border. And now, I'm gonna use packaging tape too and to tape that on. But if you do have a lot of packaging tape, I think the packaging tape looks a little bit nicer. It is shinier and can cover more area at once. I'm gonna use a long piece this time because I want it to wrap around a lot of the pitcher or the container. This part's loose down here a little bit, so I'm gonna add some more tape down there to make sure it's really sealed on completely. And you can do this with many pictures. I'm just gonna do the parsley for this example, but maybe later on my own time, I'll finish this and I'll add all the pictures. But I just wanna save you guys time so you can get to work on it. Very cool. And there's here's the blessing. There's my foil Star of David. And there's my paper parsley. And then to finish this, I would probably add all the other foods, but you could do other symbols too. You could make the wine cup that you leave out on Passover. You can make that with foil, the Hebrew letters with paper or foil. You could draw a picture of matzo ball soup and laminate it and put it on here, or a picture of your family. Whatever you feel will help you to best celebrate this tradition and this holiday. So yeah, there you go. Thank you, have fun.
So folks, there you have it. I hope you have so much fun making this. As always, if you have any questions or need ideas, email me at arosen@emanuelsf.org. And as always, we want to see what you're making. Please share them with us. Upload some photos into the shared Google Photos folder that we sent you a link to. I hope that this activity is a reminder to just really take each moment as it comes and just be. Sending love to you all. Bye.